So, I was just going through it because I came to know just now. So I thought I'll take your some practicals based something based on practical because that is also there. I think you have bought the books. Did you buy the books, all of you? If you have bought the books, then I think you must be having practical also. Do you have a practical lab manual also? Have you bought it? Have you brought the practical also? Okay. So we'll do with the first practical. So in your copy, in your classroom copy or in your notes copy, you write down the first experiment. And you're going to write it first and then I'll show you next time whenever we meet, then I will show you the practical also how it has to be done. Okay? So today you are going to write it down, the whole practical, the first experiment. It is 10th A and 10th B combined together.
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, okay. So I'll share this thing in just a minute. How many other 21? Okay, so NCERT Class 10 Science Lab Manual. This is experiment 3, but I'll make it experiment 1 because you have done with the chapter 1. You have done with the displacement reaction, decomposition, combination. Isn't it, children? Yes or no? You have done it. Okay. So, in your copy, you write down experiment number 1. First, you write down practical, chemistry practical, experiment number 1. And aim is to perform and observe the following reactions and classify them into combination, decomposition, displacement, and double displacement reaction. Okay. So it is on the display. Can you see it? Is it visible to everyone? Is it visible to everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, yes. So first of all, in the practicals, when you do, this is for the first time you're doing it. I mean, this is the first time since I'll be taking you to the lab. There we take the 10th standard to the lab and a demo is done. And one of the child is allowed to ask to do the experiment. Okay. So the first experiment is experiment number 1 is aim. So when you have the lab manual, if you have that record, if you have bought it, in that you are going to write, but later on. First of all, you write it in your rough so that I can explain you. And if possible, I can also show you the video also based on it. Okay. Because it's not like it will be only when the school reopens that we can actually do it in the lab and show it to you. All right. So first of all, write down aim as it is there. You can see the aim is there and you write down the aim. So aim is to perform. You're going to write aim. Okay. And then dash and then to perform and observe the following reactions and classify them into A, combination reaction, B, decomposition reaction, C, displacement reaction, and D, double displacement reaction. Have you written?
Yes, ma'am.
And can you read?
To perform and observe the following reactions and classify them into combination reaction, decomposition reaction, displacement reaction, and double displacement reaction. So what is the aim of your experiment? Aim is that when you perform any experiment, then that four experiments which you are going to perform, you will have to perform it, and then you have to show out of these four reactions to which reaction it will belong. Okay, so the aim is that you have to perform an experiment. Okay, what experiments? It's given there only later. So four experiments you are going to perform, and then observe that whether any reaction that is taking place in that experiment is whether it is a combination, decomposition, displacement, or double displacement reaction. Have you written till here? After this, you write down, these are the four experiments you have to do. First is action of water on quicklime. Action of water on quicklime is the first. Second is action of heat on ferrous sulfate crystals. Iron nails kept in copper sulfate solution. And fourth is reaction between sodium sulfate and barium chloride solutions. So this is the total aim. You have to perform these four experiments and then observe and then classify these four experiments into four type of reaction. So out of these four, which one is combination, which one is displacement, which one is double displacement, and which one is decomposition, that you have to classify. This is the aim of your experiment. Write it down till fourth, then you have to write down the theory. Theory means what happens, what will happen when these reactions you are going to do, these experiments when you are going to do, then what happens? Like first is the action of water on quicklime. So what will happen for when the water is added on quicklime? You know what is quicklime? It is calcium oxide. Chuna jisko kehte hain, calcium oxide. Quicklime, it is not time, okay? Action of water on quicklime, L-I-M-E, lime. This is the theory. Heading is theory. All the headings you are going to do it with the black sketch pen. Aim ko likhoge black sketch pen se and then writing karoge. Then theory again with the black sketch pen, and then you are going to use the blue pen. Action of water on quicklime, this also should be in the heading. Dark colored black pen. Quicklime is calcium oxide. It combines with water to form calcium hydroxide and is called as slaked lime. So calcium oxide, CaO, that is quicklime solid, plus H2O liquid, that is water you are adding to quicklime. Then what is the action of water on quicklime? So when it is added, the reaction occurs and you have a slaked lime as calcium hydroxide, CaOH twice, plus water is formed. Two substances are combining to form one product, isn't it? There are two substances and it only provides, it forms one product with the liberation of heat. So plus heat is also there. So because the two substances combine and form one product, so it is, hence it is a combination reaction. So out of four, first experiment is a combination reaction. Heat is released in the reaction and it is called an exothermic reaction. The next point is slaked lime solution turns red litmus blue, hence it is basic in nature. And freshly prepared slaked lime is also called as lime water. It turns milky when carbon dioxide gas is allowed to pass through it. So write it down, these points. Are you writing, everybody? Okay. And then in a record which you are going to make, you will have to write it in a very neat and clean writing. And that record is a record or lab manual which you have it or if you are going to buy it. It should be very thin. It should not be so thick. Maybe in biology and physics also, they will be telling you an experiment. So in chemistry, this is the experiment here. First, there are, I think, four experiments are there. So this is the first experiment. Here you have also to draw a diagram. So on one page, it is blank page and the other is with the line. So on a blank page, you are going to draw the diagram. And on this page, everything aim, theory. So in theory, first action of water on quicklime. This is what is the theory behind this reaction of water on a quick lime. You have this theory given here. Okay, so this much is only the first experiment. That is action of water on quicklime. These are the points. First quicklime is calcium oxide, combines with water to form calcium hydroxide, is also called as liquid lime. Second is two substances are combining to form one product, therefore it is, hence it is a combination reaction. And heat is released in the reaction, hence it is called as exothermic reaction. Then liquid lime solution turns red litmus blue, hence it is basic in nature. And the freshly prepared liquid lime is called as lime water, and it turns milky when carbon dioxide gases pass through the lime water. So these are the experiments that you will take first when you go to the lab. We are going to do it where we are going to take a quick lime in a beaker, add water to it, and what will happen? It becomes very hot. That beaker will become very hot, showing that it is a heat is produced, and the solution that is formed will be a liquid lime. And this is a combination reaction, exothermic, because it has become hot. And when you are going to take a red litmus paper available there in the lab, the red litmus paper, when you put it into the solution, liquid lime, it turns blue, showing that it is basic in nature. Red litmus turning blue is basic in nature. So calcium hydroxide is basic in nature because it has got OH minus ions. Then freshly prepared liquid lime is also called lime water. And why it is called lime water also, and what is its use? Lime water is used for testing for carbon dioxide. So when the carbon dioxide gases pass through the lime water, it turns milky. Got it? So the whole thing is there, everything. Have you written, all of you? We'll go further now. Second is action of heat on ferrous sulfate crystals. This also you have done it in the first. Can anybody tell me what happens when the ferrous sulfate crystals are heated? When ferrous sulfate is heated in a test tube, you take a green colored ferrous sulfate and directly bring it to the Bunsen burner flame. And when you heat it, then it will give some gas. Smelling will be there. There will be a burning sulfur, smell of burning sulfur. And from green, it will turn to brown because ferric oxide is formed and sulfur dioxide and sulfur trioxide gases are evolved. All right. So that is what is the reaction. So we'll, in the lab also, we have got a ferrous sulfate there, which is a light green color crystals. You take it in a test tube, directly heat it. It will start giving a smell and the pungent smell somewhat. And you have this green color becomes brownish in color, yellowish brown in color. So I think you have written it. Okay, I'm assuming that you have all written it. Then I will go to the next one. Second experiment is, that action of heat on ferrous sulfate crystals. Action of heat on ferrous sulfate crystals. So now, this is the second experiment. By the time you write it down, I'm just stuck. Battery is going to charge. Everyone can see. All of you can see, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes? Yes, ma'am. Yes, actually? Okay. So now, okay, I didn't. You can see it, no? Sachli? Tell me again.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So now, second experiment is action of heat on ferrous sulfate crystal. Ferrous sulfate crystals are light green in color. As just now I told you, ferrous sulfate is light green in color. Okay, I'll show it to you in the lab also. Or if I get the video, next time I'll show you the video if any time I get the chance for your class. The color is due to water of crystallization. This also we have done it in the first chapter, water of crystallization. Okay, and the crystals, it is crystals of light green color. So why it is crystalline? Because water of crystallization is present in that. Water is in the form of the crystal. Water is in the form of the ice. So ferrous sulfate is written here like it is on heating the crystal of ferrous sulfate. So this FeSO4.7H2O, this is the crystal of ferrous sulfate. FeSO4 is only a ferrous sulfate. But when you put a dot here and then 7H2O, then it means that ferrous sulfate is having 7 moles of H2O in the form of crystals. And these H2O are known as water of crystallization. They are light green in color and solid. Okay. Now these crystals on heating directly, when it is heated, so there should be a sign of heat on the arrow, or you write down HEAT, heat. I think everyone is writing it down. Okay. Then it will form Fe2O3, which is brown in color, ferric oxide, solid. Plus SO2 gas has evolved, which is colorless gas, and SO3 is also colorless gas. So sulfur dioxide and sulfur dioxide are formed. Now, where is the 7H2O gone? It is going in the form of water. That is, the water vapor is also evolved because you're directly heating it. So the water that is formed is also vaporizes on heating, and you get the vapors of water. So, but in your book, in your NCRT, they have not shown ferrous sulfate in the form of 7H2O. They have written only FeSO4. On heating will give Fe2O3 plus SO2 plus SO3. Only these three products have been shown in your NCRT. Okay. Now the color changes to brown and gases are released due to the formation of a new compound. Single compound decomposes to form three new compounds, and it is called as decomposition reaction. And SO2, SO3 gas turns moist blue litmus paper red, hence it is acidic in nature. These two gases are formed and water is formed, then it comes in the form of an acid. So when it comes out and moist blue litmus paper, it is moist. See, it is moist. Why it is moist? Because water in blue litmus paper having water in it will combine with SO3 to form H2SO4, sulfuric acid, and with SO2 it will form H2SO3. So because of water present, SO3 forms acid. Okay. So acid rain, you must have heard of acid rain. Acid rains are what? These sulfur dioxide in the water, in the rains when they come and it is present in the air, these two gases, then they dissolve in water present in the atmosphere and forms acid when the rain comes. So very dilute, very small amount of sulfuric acid and sulfurous acid are formed. Therefore, it will turn blue litmus paper red. But you have to take a moist blue litmus. Next point is SO2 shows reducing property. It changes the orange color of acidified dichromate to green when SO2 gas is allowed to pass through it. So this also you're going to do it in your further chapters in NCRT. Write down these points for action of heat on ferrous sulfate crystals. Okay. Have you written all of you?
No, ma'am.
Yes, okay. Ma'am.
Okay. I'll wait for some 2 more minutes, then we'll go for the third experiment. So first experiment was, what was the first experiment? It was a combination reaction where we had taken two compounds, quicklime and water. And they combined to form one compound that was calcium hydroxide. Okay, slaked lime. So that was the combination. This is the decomposition reaction. And what type of decomposition? Anybody can tell me? We have done the 3 types of decomposition. This is which type of decomposition reaction? Where ferrous sulfate decomposes to form ferric oxide, sulfur dioxide, and sulfur trioxide on heating. What type of decomposition? Forgotten, everybody?
Thermal decomposition.
Thermal, yes, thermal decomposition. Okay. So combination and decomposition, we have done it. Next will be shared displacement reaction and then double displacement reaction. Should I move further? Don't write anything here. This is not needed. Only 4-5 points. Now, this is the write down reaction between sodium sulfate and barium chloride. Okay, I think this one, huh? This is the reaction where yahan se likho. Now write down action of iron with copper sulfate. Reaction of iron with copper sulfate is the third. That is displacement reaction. Reaction of iron with the copper sulfate. Okay, that is the heading. Then write the reaction Fe solid, that is iron, which is gray in color, plus copper sulfate CuSO4, which is aqueous, and it is blue in color. Aqueous means dissolved in water, soluble in water, and it is blue solution. To form ferrous sulfate aqueous, now it turns light green, plus copper solid, which is reddish brown. You know, copper jo tamba hota, it is brownish in color, reddish brown. Okay. Now, iron nail when kept in blue colored solution of copper sulfate shows following changes. So this will do it in the lab also. We'll take a beaker containing copper sulfate and add water to it and becomes blue colored solution. So this we are going to take a nail, iron nail, and put it inside that solution. So what will happen when iron nail is kept in this blue colored solution, then blue color solution changes slowly and slowly into light green color. It starts changing from blue to light green color. The ferrous ions replace copper ions. Copper is replaced by ferrous. Iron comes here and copper is removed. And you get ferrous sulfate. So Fe plus 2 ions replace Cu plus 2 ions and form iron sulfate in the solution. And hence this is called as displacement reaction. So it is a single displacement reaction where copper is displaced by the iron. Okay. Now third point, iron nail gets deposit of reddish brown ions on it. Now iron nail which is there, nail is there and it is displacing copper. So on the nail you will see it will start becoming reddish brownish color. Why? Because this copper which is released, it deposits on the iron nail. Iron nail ke upar jama ho jata hai. Then next point, iron atom forms Fe plus 2 ions by loss of electrons, undergoes oxidation, and copper plus 2 ions gains electron to become copper atom and undergoes reduction. So these four points are there for the single displacement reaction or simply displacement reaction. And the fourth experiment is, first you write it down. Alright, so displacement reaction, have you got it? You have done it in your first chapter also about the displacement reaction experiment. And then is the next one. Reaction between sodium sulfate and barium chloride solution. So you take sodium sulfate, Na2SO4 is sodium sulfate, aqueous in water. So when it is in water, it gives out ions, Na plus ions and SO4 minus 2 ions. Similarly, barium chloride, which is an aqueous again, gives Ba plus 2 ions and Cl minus ions in water. If it is solid, it will not give. So therefore, you have to write aqueous in both the cases. So when these two react, what happens? That barium is replaced by sodium. Barium goes here and sodium comes in this in its place. So when barium goes there, it becomes barium sulfate. Instead of sodium, now barium has come there. So it becomes barium sulfate, BaSO4, which is white PPT. And sodium takes the place of barium, so it becomes NaCl. So it becomes sodium chloride. And barium sulfate is solid here, white PPT. So it is a precipitation reaction because it is not soluble in water, so it comes down and settles down below in the test tube. And sodium chloride remains in the solution. Therefore, it is an aqueous. So sodium sulfate reaction solution and barium chloride solutions are colorless. Mixing of both the solutions gives white color PPT due to the formation of barium sulfate. The exchange of ions takes place in the reaction and it is called as double displacement reaction. Okay, it is a double displacement reaction. And barium sulfate is insoluble in water and hence it forms precipitate. So all of you are writing it down. So these four experiments will be done in your lab. Okay. But if next week also, if I get a chance or substitution in your class, then I will show you this thing also, the video also, that how these four reactions can occur. And then, so this was the theory only. First was the aim. Next was second title was theory. Now third title is materials required with a sketch pen, which you have to write, materials required to do all these experiments. These are only theoretical. They were said theoretical means sirf class mein jaise batate hai na, that is theoretical. Practical is now procedure. Procedure means now you are going to do the practical, all these experiments. So how you are going to do it, what you are going to take, and then in what you are going to add test tube, and so many things, materials required. So beaker is required, four test tube is required, test tube holder, tongs, test tube stand, a dropper, a piece of sandpaper, Bunsen burner is the same burner through which you can burn it, you can heat anything. That is the materials required. Now in the next line you are going to write chemicals required. Okay, next line. Chemicals required is a small piece of quick lime, ferrosulfate crystal, iron nails, clean and unrusted. That nail should be unrusted, it should be grayish in color. Copper sulfate solution, sodium sulfate solution, barium chloride solution, and distilled water. Distilled water is the pure water. A water that does not contain any minerals in it. It is simply H2O, pure water. The chemicals required will be the next. And then the procedure. So, in the procedure, you can see there are three columns made. Okay, experiment, observation, and inference. Experiment means anything done in the lab by taking the test tube, by taking the beaker or a test tube holder, Bunsen burner, where you are heating it, where you need water and tongs and everything. So those apparatus is used and done. The experiment is done. Observation is that when you are doing certain experiment, then what you observe, what are you observing? Okay, and inference means what conclusion has been drawn, what do you conclude from that experiment. Like first one was, you take a clean beaker, add a piece, you don't write combination reaction, but only in the first point you are going to write, take a clean beaker, add a small piece of lime in it, and add water drop by drop into the beaker. So what it has taken, a beaker has been taken, and a quick lime, that is white color chuna jo hota hai na, that is small piece of that lime is put inside the beaker, in that clean dry beaker, and then water is added drop by drop. So what, when this is done, this is an experiment done, then what do you observe that some reaction is occurring and some crackling sound and steamy vapors are released, the beaker become hot. These are the observations you see. What you see, what are you looking at when you are adding water to the quick lime? Some crackling sound will be operating, aise awaaz aayegi crackling sound ki, aur fir usme se vapors niklenge. You must have seen at home also ki jab wo Nelson whitewash karta tha, he takes the quick lime, put it in a drum and then add water. So lot of steam and lot of steam, and it becomes very hot also. So steamy vapors are seen, released, and the beaker becomes hot. What do you conclude? Conclude that a combination reaction has occurred, okay? Because two calcium oxide and water reacts to give the one product. So it is a combination reaction. And what else? Exothermic also. Don't write the equation, okay? You've already written in the theory. So just write down first point. Take a clean beaker, add small piece of lime in it, and add water drop by drop into the beaker. Observation, reaction occurs with crackling sound and steamy vapors are released. The beaker becomes hot. Inference, an exothermic and combination reaction has occurred. Whenever I have your 10th standard class, so on Wednesday, 10th B, then I'll continue with this, because the time is only 3-4 minutes are left. So you're writing it down also, so that will take time. So before I will start with the class in 10th B, I'll complete this experiment, okay? All these procedure. So don't worry. And you can share it with 10th or I'll send this thing to your class. See, there are four experiments and then the precautions and then end. That is what. इतना होता है इसमें. वाइवा वोसी मतलब जब भी practicals is there, no, the marks are given on the basis of experiment and as well as वाइवा. वाइवा means oral. Orally it is asked. Give the example of two combination reaction. When ferrous sulfate is heated, what type of decomposition it is, or what gases are evolved, why it turns brown. All these are the viva. Verbally it is asked. So in 12th standard, external sits there and external examiner come from other school and child is sitting in front and he starts asking the question. Why lime water turns milky? Even in 12th standard, they ask why lime water turns milky and children are not able to answer. 12th, they forgot. Why the lime water turns milky? Because of the formation of calcium carbonate. Okay, so this is in 10th only you have studied, but when they reach by 12th, they forget everything. So all these four experiments, we'll do it later on because the time is only 3 minutes. You can write it on the second also if you can, if possible. Only experiment, don't try decomposition reaction. Second is, take a clean dry test tube, add few crystals of ferrous sulfate, fix it on a test tube holder, heat test tube on burner, keeping the mouth of test tube away from your face, waft the gas, waft means remove, haath se usko hatana, waft the gas release to smell and test it with acidified potassium dichromate paper. Green crystals becomes reddish brown, tiny droplets of water are settled near the neck of the test tube and a colorless gas is evolved. Acidified dichromate paper, potassium dichromate changes its color from orange to green. What is the inference? Inference is that decomposition reaction has occurred and water of crystallization is also collected on the test tube and the smell of the gas is due to the sulfur dioxide and sulfur trioxide formed. You can write it down. Till here, till decomposition if it is possible, and then after 1 minute you can leave. 1 minute is still there, so after that you can leave. Write it in your notes copy till here, and then when we'll meet in on Wednesday when I'll have a class, then I will continue with this two more experiment and precaution. So that way, and if possible I'll show you the video also of these experiments, and then we'll start with the acid base that we were doing. In the acid, base and salt, we are left with the pH. We have done it only half. pH in the daily life and the salts. So that will finish off. And the second chapter will also, we will be doing it. We will be finishing off the second chapter also. Small, I think two periods to have on Wednesday and Thursday. So we'll finish off with that chapter.